In this screencast, we are going to examine the draining of a spherical tank with time. This implies that there is an unsteady state balance. We will make certain assumptions to be able to use the Bernoulli equation to model the draining of this particular tank. So we have a spherical tank with a radius we'll call large R, and we'll have a drain down here that we'll say has a radius of small r. Now when we start any type of problem, it's important that we start labeling our diagram. So if we say that the water level is initially at the top, we'll call this point 1, and we'll say where it drains is point 2. Now we assume that the fluid follows some kind of streamline into the drain and out. We're also going to assume that the fluid is in viscid, and last, that it's incompressible. This allows us to write our equation of interest for this problem, the Bernoulli equation. Thus, we have our simplified Bernoulli equation. Now, in the problem statement, it says that there is a vent at the top of the tank. This means that the pressure at point 1 is going to be equal to the pressure at point 2, which we're going to say is 0, since we could use a gauge pressure. So these drop out of the equation, and so does Z2. We're going to say that the liquid level height here at Z2 is 0. So we've already gotten rid of half of our terms. We know that the change in the fluid height is going to change with time. So we could write that as the change in height with time. And it's negative because we've set our axis to be in the positive direction. So now the last unknown we have is the velocity at point 2. And so we want to solve for that. But we have a differential at point 1. What we're going to say is the velocity at point 1 is going to be much lower than that at point 2. And the reason for this is we're going to assume that the diameter at point 1 is much greater than that at point 2. You could imagine for a very large diameter tank with a very small drain pipe, the change in fluid height is going to be very small compared to the actual velocity of fluid coming out of that drain pipe. So although the velocity, the change in height with time, is not equal to 0, we assume what's called a quasi-steady state, where we basically use the steady state approximation to get our velocity at point 2. This gives us what's also known as the free jet approximation, where the velocity coming out of the drain is the square root of 2 times the gravitational constant times the height from our point 2. At this point, we still want a good relationship between V2 and V1, and so this is where we bring in the continuity equation that declares that the mass flow rate at point 1 must be the mass flow rate at point 2. Since it's incompressible, the density is constant, we could balance the volumetric flow rates at these two points as such, where volumetric flow rate is the velocity at point 1 times the cross-sectional area at point 1, and therefore this must be equal to the velocity at point 2 times the cross-sectional area at point 2. Now we have expressions for V1 and V2, and we could calculate A1 and A2. Now the cross-sectional area of the drain pipe is going to be just pi r squared. However, as this fluid height changes, our cross-sectional area is also going to change with time. This may be non-intuitive, but we could use geometry to give us a nice relationship between the height of the fluid and the radius of that cross-section. Now let's pretend this is our sphere and it has a radius big R, and we'll draw two fluid heights so that we could demonstrate this. One that's kind of that's well above the center of the sphere, and one that's below the center of the sphere. Now if we draw a triangle from that center straight up into the end there, we know that this is going to be our radius that's changing with time. We also know that this at the bottom of the sphere we've labeled as 0, so the height from the bottom to that water level we're designating as h of t. Now we could draw this triangle, and we see that we have the radius as a function of time, the radius of the sphere, and the height of the sphere minus the radius of the sphere, since this distance right here is also r. Using Pythagorean theorem, we could say that r squared is going to be equal to the radius as a function of time squared plus h of t minus r squared. And we want to isolate out the radius as a function of time as a function of the height. So doing so, we get the following. And all I've done here is expanded and simplified so that we have the radius as a function of time for the fluid level. Now lastly, I want to also demonstrate that this same equation holds here. And the only difference is that when we draw this triangle, this time this is going to be r minus h as a function of time. But since we're squaring that term, it ends up becoming the same thing. So now we know that the area at point 1 is going to be pi times 2h r minus h squared. And the area at point 2 is just going to be pi times little r squared. Recall that our velocity 1 is the change in height with time, and our velocity 2 is the square root of 2gh. We'll plug that in with our areas and see what we get. Now, I've written it here as such with the square root of h on the right side so that you can see we can bring all of the h terms to the left side and separate out our variables. We're going to integrate both sides of this equation on the left from some initial height to some final height, and on the right from some initial time 0 to some time t. And when we integrate this, and I would suggest breaking up this term here, we get the following. And we want t to be a function of the height, so I'm just going to take t, put it on the left side, and divide by the square root of 2g times the r squared. So now we have an equation to model the time it takes to empty our spherical tank. Now we know that a full tank has an initial height of 2 times the radius, and our final height, if we were emptying the tank, is 0. So plugging these values into this equation, we get the following. So the time to drain a full tank of a fluid will depend on the large radius of the tank, the small radius of the drain hole, and then the gravitational constant. And that will give you the time.